Hey everybody and welcome back. My name is Sue and I'm from OML Embroidery and today we're going to be going through the April 2021 All Access with my kind of grouchy husband over here, Don.
I'm not grouchy.
You kind of are.
No.
Kind of whiny then. So I love this right here, new technique that catches my attention right away. For sure.
That's actually really cool.
I think it's fringe.
It looks like fringe.
Yeah. I wish the pages turned better.
It's, I know.
Kind of annoying. Ooh, look at this. Ooh, beautiful.
And pencil holders.
Crazy blanket stitch quilt. Ooh. Release radar.
You like crazy quilts.
I love blanket stitch, too. Modular passport wallets. Pack your bags.
That's pretty cool.
It's actually beautiful, isn't it? Loop fringe. Oh, I would like to learn that. Thank you very much. Decorative stitch words. Okay. Beautiful. I love typography. I love these. It's so pretty. Oh.
I like those.
Oh my god.
We need those.
That's so cute.
We need those in the kitchen.
So long. So long.
Yep.
Crazy blanket stitch quilt. All right. I'm going to love this. This is cool. The crazy quilting is inside the applique.
That's kind of neat. I like the laminate.
That's gorgeous. What a great idea. I don't think I've ever seen that before. Great for scraps, too. Mm-hmm. I really like the chicken. Oh, wow. Look at them all. Oh, books.
The cow's cool.
I like the teapot. That's awesome. Oh, yeah. The cow is really cool. And look, you can mix and match. I love when they give the ideas for the mix and match.
Looks like little placemats.
Isn't that cute? I love it. I love the farmhouse right there.
It's very nice.
So, 11 by 16, which I'm going to stitch out one when I get my new machine just because
you can.
It's AAA. I would like to be a AAA. All the way down to 5 by 7, which is really nice. So, there's square, large, and small rectangle blocks. Love it. Love it. Stitching out a block. Applique.
Always such good instructions.
I know. It makes it so much easier to do.
It does.
Now, this one is really cute. Oh, I love it. With a carrot, a crazy quilt carrot. I love it. That's cool.
You're a crazy quilt carrot.
Probably, yes.
Ooh, blueberries.
And you put the edges on it as well. Oh, I like the little swirlies. Look at the blueberries. Well,
they did a blanket stitch around the blueberries. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. I think it was a crazy blanket stitch quilt. Hence the blanket stitches.
On everything. Yep.
I really like this fabric swatch chart. That's really helpful.
It is.
And I love putting the sashing in when you're doing the blocks. Yeah, the lemonade. Look at the carrot close up. Isn't that cool?
It's very cool.
I like the swatches. I think that's really neat.
It's a cool idea.
So they have a flowery one, they have a checkered one, and then kind of like a sparse design one. A layer cake would be perfect for doing something like this.
Yeah, it would.
Yeah, different prints. Okay, for some reason I love the lemonade. This is a milk can.
Yeah.
Bathtub is cool. I really like that fabric there. That's kind of groovy. Yes, the rooster. The cow, there's your cow.
He's patchwork, all right.
He's patchwork. Well done. I am going to really enjoy stitching this out. Oh, and then these are the rectangle ones. Oh, the eggs. And a spade for gardening. Oh, milk. This is what I like. The books. I would almost put the books in between all of them. Match the colors. Mm-hmm. Oh, apple. Oh, I love it.
Now, is that a flower or a sun? Because it could be either one.
Sunflower?
Maybe.
Either one. They'll probably give it a name. Birdhouse? Star? Oh, candle. Isn't that pretty? Oh, isn't that pretty? Yeah. I could see it, like, with different colors, brighter colors. And the chicken and the egg. Oh, watering can. Oh, wellies. Rubber boots. Oh, I love the orange look of it.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, they have such... Oh, blueberries. There's my teapot.
Teapot.
I love the teapot. Ah, then you put it all together. Yeah, that's really cute. Really cute. Oh, you're going to love this, Don. Punny food trucks. Facetious food trucks. Awesome. Serving some punny delights. So it says nice buns.
Oh, I want that on a shirt.
I like that. What that do you think?
Cool. Yeah, I want one on a shirt.
Say cheese. So stitching out a food truck. So applique. Ooh, is that cork? Because that looks
like cork, yeah.
Yeah. A little bit of trim in. Oh, yeah. I love how they did the windows.
That's really cool.
Little more applique. And then all of the detail, which there is a lot.
Taco truck.
Whole Foods.
I want taco truck.
I like it.
And I like the nice buns.
I bet. Nice buns. There we go. What the scoop. That's my level.
Frank's a lot.
Peas on Earth. Sam would like that, being vegan she is. Say cheese. Love. Oh, it's pizza. Sushi.
Shrimply the best.
Well, they're on point, aren't they? That is, I think Shrimply the best is awesome. Yeah, wouldn't that be cute in the kitchen?
Yeah, it would.
Taco store. That's awesome. Oh, look. Casserole holder. I love it when they take one design and then show you how to use that design in something completely different. Which is what they're doing now. How to make the casserole holder. Which, it doesn't look too difficult at all. This will be sewing, not embroidery. But really cool. Because I wouldn't know how to do that. Every little detail, turn it right side in, do this, sew it here. I could follow the instructions. Yeah, that's
pretty cool.
Yeah, that's awesome.
I think the casserole holder is a cool idea.
Yeah. I'm not sure what a casserole is. Do we eat casseroles?
Not very often.
No.
Our cauliflower bake could be considered a casserole.
Okay, just vegetarian.
Yeah.
I love these. I love these. Even if you didn't make one of these flower pots or little bags or whatever.
Just the design itself.
Just the design is spectacular. Very pretty, yeah. About the details. Yeah, like this. You could make, or for pens.
Candies.
Oh, I really like that. I really like that. Materials list, so they tell you everything you need. Remember when we went to Anita Goodesign and we saw all their threads?
Can we go again?
They moved, so I don't know if it's going to be quite the way it was.
And I want to go again.
No, not yet. They won't be having any garage sales. We could go just to see Taylor and Lane, though.
Yay.
Okay, we can do that. Yeah, for sure. Happy Mother's Day. I love it. I guess Mother's Day is coming up.
Yeah, it is.
Nice. Assembling your project. Oh, cool. That's iron on to put it together. Very nice. Oh, yeah. And then you cut it out. Quickly sew it together. Square off the bottom. Nice. But the design like this, you could do anything with it.
Mm-hmm.
Frame it. I mean, this is... frameable. You're the best. Mom.
Oh, thanks.
Dawn.
I'm the best Dawn ever.
Please don't get... I might have to add an extra word to that. Strong as a mother. There's space. They left space.
Sue.
Dawn. Best mom ever. This is my favorite one. I don't know why.
Mama Bear.
I love it. Oh, yeah. Mama Bear. Mother like no other. Yep, for sure. Check these sneak peeks out. Okay, I love sneak peeks. Look at this.
I like that. Ooh. I like how they're doing all black and then just one color.
That's stunning when they do that. I really like that. Jungle Jamble. Ooh, I like these guys. Flamingos. Folded fabric savannah sunsets. Well, that's beautiful. That's beautiful. Okay, so fringe. And this is loop fringe. There's different ways of doing it. It is a brilliant effect. See how the loops come out?
Yeah.
Look at this for the nest. Fringe with a twist. Oh, it's so cute. Isn't that cute? And that's like fuzzy. I think it's awesome. Fabric, threads. See, what you do is you stitch these long satin stitches or wide satin stitches, and then you cut the bobbin at the back, and then you fluff it all up. They come out the front in a loop.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's a wonderful technique. So creating loop fringe embroidery. I love a new technique. I love it. So they tell you how to do it, the stitching. See, it doesn't look like anything there, but look over here.
Yeah, looks a lot better.
So you just use your seam ripper and, yeah, it's like a 3D design. This I love. I think this, the nest is beautiful. Oh, snowman. He's so cute.
And a bee.
A bee for bee. She might like that bee. And then just a design. I like that too. And a flower. Oh, the center of the flower. So much fringe. Yeah, I really like the nest. I think that's fantastic. Loop fringe is perfect for adding fun visual texture to the design while still being simple as standard stitching. True.
The nest is very cute.
Yeah, something about it just catches my attention.
I like that.
Yes, this was a quilt that they, right here. Right here. I remember looking at it, and it's really cool the way, like, the little decorations are fringed. It's beautiful. Collections. Oh, and they have more.
Oh, I like the Christmas fringe.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Yes.
Christmas fringe. Fringe flowers. And I know I have this one, geometric fringe quilt. I remember looking at it. Oh, Mama and Minnie. Aww. I like That's that. Cute. That's cute. Oh, there's more. But wait, there's more. Two snails. Actually, that's really cute. I like how they're kind of cut out, like the designs kind of cut out. So, stitching out your design. Hoop and put your fabric down. Oh, so the background is fabric. I see. I see. Trim it and then do some stitching. And they're beautiful.
I like the gorilla.
That's so well done, isn't it? I like it. I like it. I like these guys.
Yeah.
And the snails. I don't really snails. Like snails.
They actually look really
but
cool.
But they're cute. Animal trivets. Keep that kitchen cute. This is the cutest.
Oh, we need at least one of each of those.
Okay, well, there might be more. Oh, there's more. And a pig.
That's why I said one of each, because it includes anything.
Planning your project. Okay. Materials, what do you need? Base fabric, applique fabric, batting, Insulbrite batting. So the Insulbrite is what keeps the heat away. Tearaway stabilizer, no-show mesh stabilizer, embroidery thread, and spool of all-purpose sewing thread. Okay, so this one has like the ears are sticking out. This is like the bag that I did.
And his feet too.
So you have to do those first, and you do them on tearaway, and they're just quick little appliques, almost like little patches on tearaway. Once that's done, and they're nice on the front and the back, so they put the fabric down on the back and then do satin stitches. See how perfect they look? Yeah. And then they tear out really easily too. So that's easy. Now, the second hooping, and this is on the no-show mesh, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
Yes. So outline Insel Bright first. See, that's something I would never know. I'm glad they do it that way. It's awesome. Put the Insel Bright first. Continue to the next machine step will be the tacking down. Then you trim it out. And, ooh, okay. Place your fabric face up, covering the whole thing. And then you're going to trim it out and do your appliques. And you keep going, applique and stitches. Oh, he's so cute. And then you're going to put the feet. There'll be lines. I'm sure it was easy to do on the bag. And then you're going to cover it over, and it's going to stitch down but leave an opening right here. And then take it off.
A flippy one.
Yeah, take it off the hoop, trim it out, and this is what you get.
That's cute.
That is super cute. I'm going to have to do it.
Oh, yeah, bunny rabbit.
Bunny! Oh, I love his ears. So cute. Oh, an owl. Moo?
Moo.
He's cute. Raccoon. Kitty cat. Oh my goodness, these are adorable.
Dog.
You know what? If you skip the Insel Bright, they would just be really super cute mug rugs. Mm-hmm. For sure. You could add a zipper backing and make little zip bags. I love it. Oh, more sneak peeks. Two styles. Oh, that is so pretty. The birds. Benjamin Bunny. I like that. Ooh.
Neat.
Neat.
I like the mini mesh flower hoops.
Oh. Stitch your own garden. Floating and it's stitched right on mesh?
Yeah.
How?
Put in little
wow.
That's neat.
That's beautiful. What a great idea. Now, these embroidery hoops, I couldn't hold it in anymore.
They're craft hoops.
Well, embroidery hoops, yeah. Whatever. They're not very expensive to buy, which is nice. Creating your design. Two pieces of wash away and placement, and then put the mesh. I see, and then stitch. That's really cool. And then when you wash away the wash away, you're just left with the mesh.
That's pretty cool.
That's really cute. Oh, they're beautiful. I like this one. That one catches my attention.
I like the blue one.
And I like that too. I was just like,
ooh. The red and pink one.
Ooh. This is another thing that they're doing. Yeah, because what's better than these beautifully stitched flowers with a built-in frame kind of thing? Little butterflies to go with it. And then they show you how to do all that.
They're just a solid color silhouette butterfly. That's cool.
Isn't that cool? Yeah. You got to have your bobbin matching.
Yeah.
Oh, and you can do more than one, so they show you how to merge it over. Perfect. And wash it away. So it's like freestanding. Very cool. Yeah, and then very carefully hot glue it. So they've done the mesh, and they've done like organza or something behind it. And then
oh, that's neat.
Add your butterflies, and you're just going to leave it square. Beautiful.
Hmm.
Passport wallets. That looks like an iPhone, not a passport. That would be cool. An iPhone, anything.
Yeah.
We're not going anywhere for a while, so we don't need our passports. Well done, though.
Yeah, bonjour. It's nice.
I love that. Gathering the essentials. Oh, out of jean. Oh.
That's pretty cool.
So, denim, lining fabric, pocket fabric, secondary pocket fabric, applique fabric. Okay. This is cool.
I like the fabrics they're using.
Beautiful, isn't it?
They are.
I know. And how to do everything, because I would not know how to put pockets and stuff in it. I like it that it's denim. I'm glad we're not live.
Are we keeping you up?
It's been a tough couple of weeks. So, stitch it out, cut it out. There's a couple of hoopings for this one, but that's just fine. So, this is really cool. Oh, that's how you make a pocket. You just fold it and then stitch it down like folded fabric.
Oh.
Ha! Did you know that?
I did not know that.
Me neither. And then put it all together by putting your denim on the top. Wow. That's pretty easy. And then you turn it in.
Cut and flip, too.
Yeah. Yeah. That's cool.
Huh.
Hello, world. Explore. I like the bonjour. Let's go. Pack your bags. That's awesome. I like how on the back of it, that there's a little matching design. Oh, that's so cute. That's nice. So cute. Oh, I like this. Hmm. I like this. And different setups for pockets and stuff.
Yeah, it's neat.
It's hard to see this one, but it's different as well. Ooh, decorative stitch words. Motifs meant to inspire. That, is that candle wicking?
It looks like it.
Beautiful. Be you. Thankful. Really nice. Really nice materials. I'm going to guess that that's candle wicking. So beautiful. Breathe. Fearless. Loved. Blessed. Yeah, they're all beautiful. You can always add these designs to other things. Dreamer. Oh, I love that. Dreamer. All the swirlies are so pretty. Be brave. Mm-hmm. Believe.
Shine bright.
This one's different. Stitches.
Yeah, I think they're all slightly different.
Yeah, I bet you they are. Shine bright. I love it. Inspire. Be kind. Beautiful. Why, thank you. Be you.
Thanks. Mm. I will.
Oh. I like the cookie. I like the cookie. We say that all the time. It's from a Disney movie. I like the cookie. And then here's all the designs that you get with your digital copy. And what's really cool about the digital copies is what I do is I copy this onto my iCloud. And then tonight I'll sit and read everything and go through it. I think this technique is really cool. I am for sure going to do this nest because I think it's beautiful.
I'm going to do a taco truck.
You can.
Although I got some catching up to do because I have some other ones I want to do and I haven't done yet either.
Well, you should make the time to do it. And the passports, that is a really good learning, you know, pockets and different things like that. And, mm-hmm. of course, the lettering. So, these are the releases. Oh, yeah. Crazy Quilt Blanket Stitch. Yeah, I'm cool with that one. And the trivets are mug rugs. I might make it into a mug rug. I have a little bit of the Insul Bright, but I think we'd use it more as a mug rug.
Probably.
I'll make the piggy for Bee because she likes piggies. I don't know. I think the rooster for me. Maybe. Woo! So, that was awesome.
I'm a cow.
We had to... Don't have a cow, man. Don't have a cow.
Okay.
It's a bull, I think. Which, it's, you know, that suits you too.
Mm-hmm. Bull.
All right. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Sorry for the wait. There was a little mix-up down at Anita Goodesign, but Taylor sorted me out, and it was killing me to wait an extra 3 days.
It was. She was driving me crazy.
I know. It's just, I've been doing this for a while, and I love the designs. I'm really happy with all of these. I like the fringe. I like the lettering because it's gorgeous. The quilting one is going to be a lot of fun. I'm going to dig through my layer cakes. But also the trivets and the mom ones.
My favorites are the mini mesh flower hoops.
Oh, yeah. You like those?
Yeah. And the facetious food trucks.
Food trucks with attitude. Yes. Attitude. So, we'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, everyone.
Bye, everyone.